Hi, you guys, it's Asha here. Oh my goodness, what's happened here? It's sticking out again, really? What the hell? Where should I look, really? This disaster is too much light, too much light, too much light. Can I change it when I'm recording to see the other side of the... No. Noises or techniques or... No, not techniques. Hi, you guys, it's Asha here. And so weird to actually talk to you like that. Okay, today, in today's video, a very first one like that. So if you like it, please let me know so I can continue. Otherwise, there is no point. I wanted to show you my tips and my tricks on how to organize your products and on how to manage your crafty space. To be more or less clean, to have at any point possibility of finding what you are looking for. So there are still gonna be some tips and tricks I need to tell you about. I think I'm gonna do better in the next video because I seriously don't know where I should look. this is disastrous. And if you enjoy this one and if you find that you want to know more, there are gonna be things probably I forgot to put in this one, and I can put in the next one and I can share with you, because I remember when I started and I had not that many products and I had no idea where to put them. I learned a lot by myself, but the most I learned from watching other tutorials, and I advise you to watch them, because sometimes you find in the most unexpected places you find solutions which can help you a lot. I am proud of what I've done with the space I have. I have to tell you, when I craft, I have a mess. Everything here on my craft space is messy, but that's normal also. I cannot just, you know, do one stamp, clean it and put it back in the folder. This is not going to work for me. You know, I don't need to be perfectionist when I'm doing my job, as long as everything at the end of the day is clean and fine, and it does not even, well, in my case, it has to be clean because I'm working in my living room. Okay, let me start with showing you my craft room. So here we go, guys. This is it. This is my craft space. Here we go, my light, my other light, which is falling constantly because I put the swatches here, and well, and here I have a tiny bit of my craft space, but not that, it's not really a craft space, it's just a space to push things around when I am working and later clean it. And so here it is. This is my space. Today is not super clean, to be honest. Oh, it's not also messy. So my tip number one, sorry for the wobbly hands because, well, I'm holding my camera. This is my workspace. So how it looks like. I bought this beautiful thing. It's a fabric. Like that, you can see even the strings coming out. And it's called a photo background. I'll try to give you links to things like that in the description box below, but basically it's a photo background you can buy on Amazon or eBay. On top of that, I put this plastic bureau protection cover. This one is from IKEA. Although last time I was there and I couldn't find a second one. I love it. I absolutely love it because, first of all, it's see-through. So you can actually, when you put a nice background underneath, you can see the beautiful background when you do your videos. And on top of that, it's very easy to clean, but it's not like the mats you know, you can buy from Ken Olivier or Tim Holtz. So if you make a scratch in it, it's gonna stay. If you really make it dirty, the dirt is gonna stay a little bit encrusted in the mat. But in general, it's very easy to clean, and if you clean straight away, it works perfect. The only problem, it can bend if you use the heat gun on it. So, and I've done it actually, it's bended here. So that's why I want to buy a second one. But as I said, I cannot find it, and it's quite big also. It's finishing over here, so it's quite big. Here I have a tablecloth. It's just this thing which, you know, you cannot get the paint through. To avoid it getting burned, you can simply use that. This is my chipping board, which is broken. I use a lot of bamboo in the house. Okay, it's in a very bad state because I'm doing a lot of embossing on it. Sometimes there is a drops of paint also which are falling, but that's not a problem. I can just put my thing to emboss or to dry on it, and I always have it at hand just beside. Two notebooks which are necessary for me to work. First of all, I have to tell you, I learn everything from the beginning. So this is my, those are my notes. If you think I knew everything because I don't know, I have a background in IT or in photography, you are very much mistaken. So I learn everything by watching, asking Google or watching tutorials on YouTube, and everything I know, not to forget, I'm putting in the notebook like that. And this is my notebook, which I use at least once a week. Still, I add things to it and I check the things. This is my second notebook. You may probably have seen it because sometimes I put it under my art journaling when I'm doing it. And this is the notebook where I, as you can see, I do a little bit of doodling. But what I do, and I know that other girls do that also, is when I'm doing my project, I actually put down all the materials I use. Because I don't always use the, I don't always make videos, and sometimes I'm getting lost also. It's normal if you have a lot of products. So that's what I'm doing. There are almost all of my projects. Well, no, this is not the first book like that, so not all of my projects, but from this year, I have them in my notebook. This is very useful. You will not get confused, you will not get lost. You just keep it on the side when you are doing your project, write down what you are doing it with, and voila, like that you will never forget. And if you have questions from people, and that happens quite often, just open your book and you have it. These are my two beautiful wooden boxes which I bought, I think, for 50 cents each. I have a very nice shop, like a pawn shop here around, and sometimes I can buy cheap stuff like this one even. I love it. And so these are my first aid boxes, basically. I have here the most important stuff, but I don't use that, but I have my Lindy sticker here. Then I have my crackle accents, glossy accents, which I use quite often. Crackle accents are amazing. Crackle accents and white crackle paste from Finavar, they are just amazing. Some pearls, and of course my embossing powders, but only two of them, black and white, they are both from Lindy's. And this is my anti-static cushion, that's the cushion number two. I made it by myself, and as you can see, I left the strings hanging because I love it. So basically I sew it on my sewing machine, and inside I put some corn flour. I'm gonna check for you. If you don't have to, also mix it with the baby powder. And I'll try to put it for you in the description box below, because the homemade will save you a lot of money and you can do it perfectly. You don't even have to have a sewing machine, of course. And yes, it's saving money and it's working perfectly. So here I have, those are actually my stamps, so I left them here to use them as often as possible. Okay, this one is not mine actually, this one is from AB Studio, I still didn't work with it. But those are my stamps, and I have them here always at hand. They are not all of them here, but yes, they are here. And then I also have this beautiful laser cut stuff from Artos. This one I still didn't work with. So that's why they are here, because I want to use them as often as possible. My acrylic blocks and the post-it, which I need. This is old acrylic block. Then those are the things I bought recently, and I need to use them. So the washi tape and the stamps from Color Create. And this is the stick pictures I've made. So I keep them at hand because like that I have a reminder of things I would like to use in my next projects because they are new or because they are mine. How I keep my embossing powders. I keep them like that in a box. I don't have any other choice. I would like to have a set of drawers. They are in, well, it's a mess a little here. But I don't care about that as long as I have my swatches. But I have what I have and I'm dealing with it, so that's how it is. The swatches are very important, especially because those are Lindy's embossing powders and a lot of them are two-toned. Two-toned means that they are giving you different color depending if they are on the black or white surface. Those are one-toned, so you can see on the black and on the white surface they look the same. And this one, for example, it looks differently depending on which surface you apply it to. So that's why I always have my swatches. And that's the first thing I do when I get new products, I'll do the swatches. It's very important and it helps you a lot. And you can do your projects much easier and much quicker if you have swatches like that. You just put the swatch next to the project and you know straight away, or almost straight away, which product, which color to use. Okay guys, those are my scrap papers. I keep them and I kind of segregate them into different or two different bunches of papers. They are small ones, different colors, white and black and all with all the nice colors. Those are more or less white, but you can see also a cream or beige inside. And those are black and colored also. I put elastic around them like that, they stay together. I have a lot of pieces like that because I do a lot of bookmarks, so that's why. But they are very useful and I tell you what, why. First of all, if you use stickers, like you know, word stickers from, I don't know, from Maremi Small Art or from 7 Dot Studio or even from Tim Holtz, and you want to add a little bit more of startiness to them, you just place them on the piece of paper like that and you cut it out and you have it. If you want to try your stamps or make some stamped image and then cut it out, this is a piece of paper which costs a lot if you buy it in a, you know, like a block of it. So it's better to keep it like that. Also to check your stamps if they work fine or to check the embossing powder. The other things why they are perfect for, it's for Lindy's or for your swatches. When you place the swatches, okay, this one doesn't have a cup, this one has a cup, like that. If you place your swatch, you need a circle, so you take your hole puncher and you punch it along. I just thought about another idea for that. It's a, how do you call it, it's art journaling with collaging. So if you want to do some texture and you build up your art journaling or any other projects for that matter, you can use the pieces of paper like that. They are, you see, different size. They are different texture that will work perfectly for your product. Okay, so this is one of the folder I have. And in this folder, I arrange my stickers. I used to have them in a box. And I have to tell you, some of the stickers were coming off because there was too many papers and all of that. So I decided to put them like that. And here you can see I cut them in half. They are word 7 Dot Studio word stickers, so they are long. I cut them in half and put one side here, and I left the title so like that I know what I'm working on. And this is another one again with the name. Can you see that? Yes, you can. And I also, because they were falling, I put the washi tape, so I'll keep them in place. And this is what I'm talking about, you know, there are some of the parts of the stickers I already either used or they were getting unglued. So here are all my paper stickers, super easy to find. First of all, I already know which color to look for. Then what kind of writing, if it's smaller writing or a big one, if it's just like in a case of small talk sentences or in case of chit chat, just single words. So that way, I really, really love this way of keeping stuff. I put them on the piece of paper from printer and I glue them with the washi tape. But I guess you can glue them also with glue if you prefer. But with washi tape, you can always take them out. These are also sentiments, although they are ribbons, but I don't mind. These ones are from Maremi Small Art, the new ones. And then I have a little bit from AB Studio. And here there is a little bit more from AB Studio. They actually moved those two. I have to fix them. But I kind of cut them out because when I'm getting new papers, I like to fuzzy cut things and keep them later already cut it. So that's what I've done here. I had a lot of fuzzy cut things and they are all over the paper. So that's why I cannot keep them this way. I would prefer, but you know, I have them here. Then I also take the pieces of narrative from the old books. And when I find something interesting, like creator of the universe, I'll just place it here and like that for next time. If I fancy something like that, I'll have it. These ones are word stickers from Mixed Up Creative. And these ones are the ones I don't really like, but I bought them at some point at the very beginning of my art journaling adventure. And this is Jane Davenport. They are actually for the bullet journal, but I use them from time to time because I like a little bit in French, especially for cards, for card making, a little bit for Christmas. So my Christmas stuff is on one side. There is also a Halloween with Christmas. I always put Halloween with Christmas. Then I have again a little bit of French ribbons. And now I have printables. So I have mixed up printables. Then I have again mixed up printables. And I got these ones from my friend Linda Finney. Thank you so much again, Linda. I work with them from time to time. I love them. And then I have my rice papers. I don't have too much rice papers, but the ones I have are from Maremi Small Art. They are beautiful. I still haven't worked with them yet, but I'm gonna. And then I have also this transfer paper from Stamperia and the rice paper also from Stamperia. Beautiful papers. So I either put them in these plastic pockets or I just make the holes if there is a place and just put them like that. And this comes from my handmade stickers. Voila, they are my handmade stickers here. And I actually like very much when I take out or when I took out the you know, the borders. I like them so much that I decided to use them for my projects. I already did one project with that. And this I keep also because I like very much the texture. So, and then I have another folder, and this one is with die cuts. So my idea for die cuts, I either put them the dies and the die cuts together or I don't. Depends. These ones are die cuts from Tin Leads by Tim Holtz. So they come in with a small plastic envelopes and I basically have no place to put them. They are quite thick. So I leave them like that. I know them well. I know where they are coming from. So I leave them like that. So here I have again Tim Holtz dies. This I got from, I think, MacArt when we exchanged our ATC cards. So I don't really know where it comes from. And here I have my fantasy dies. And fantasy dies I actually keep at least some of them together with the dies. I cut sometimes on the black paper, on the craft paper and on the white paper. Depends really what I have at hand. Again, beautiful fantasy die. I love this one. And that's the newest one I bought. It's the Kaiser Craft. I really love that. And here I have some dies, but I also keep the leftovers basically. I keep the leftovers because, but look at that, guys. I have two of them here. I'm thinking that will work for a stencil, as a stencil for, you know, one application. And those, they would be perfect to actually build some 3D project, you know, some kind of layers. Because look at that, when you put it even like that, you already have these beautiful, beautiful layers. So sometimes just keep those things if you can, and don't show them out, and they can really serve you well. Okay, they are pain. They are they are very big pain when it comes to putting them to the packets. The packets I bought on internet, it was an investment, and I had some of them, and some of them I bought in this cheap shop. But you know, if you want to organize your things better, you need to unfortunately invest a little bit. This is actually not a die. This is my doodling, which I cut out later, so it's not a die, but I made so many of them that I put them here. This one is another one which I really love. It's from what kind of die? Studio Light. And here we go. This is Karin and DIYNC. And I put them like that. And this actually, this pocket in particular, I think it did not cost me even 1 euro for like 50 of them. And I love that so much. So what I've done here is I have four of them, of the dies here. So I put them here in the four packets. And this one I put at the back. And that's what I've done. This is how my dies look like. Some of them have boxes, some of them have just dies. So like that look, guys. I see here, okay, here I have a die, but just one. Here of this one I have nothing. So I know next time when I take out my cattle bag, which is hidden very, very deep in the wardrobe because of the lack of space. So when I take the next time the cattle bag, I'll just go through that and I'll see, okay, here I have only two, so probably I will need more of those. Here I have nothing, so I have to make them. Here I have quite a lot, so I leave them be. And so like that, it's very clear, you know, very, very clear and very easy to manage. And well, you don't waste your time on, you know, going through that. Okay, you always have to put them back in the proper places, but if you get used to it, you know where the things go. And here I left a little bit of, you know, these leaves. I have no idea how they are called properly. And then I have a little bit of my embossing, thinking maybe I'll do some, how do you call it, ATC cards. Then I have this one, which is beautiful also. And I close them with a washi tape again. Ciach. And then I have a pieces for the card making also. You know, I cut it out. I had my die, but on top of that, I was left with the piece of which I can use for the cards. Okay, that's the next thing. And I have three folders here, and I have to tell you, they all look differently because first of all, I am not too much on spending money on the things I already have. So basically a lot of those folders are coming from my studying years, from the life in general. So they are mismatched. I don't care about that too much. Anyway, not for now. It does not look beautiful, but I don't like to also use things and throw them just to buy something else. So I keep them like I keep them. And in these folders, I have my stencils. You must think, some of you, that I have a lot. Believe me, I started, I had nothing. And these are coming from my DT work. I think I didn't buy even one from those stencils here. They are from Snibart, for which I was working last year. And those are from Aga Baraniak, so AB Studio. I made holes in them, or some of them have already these things here to attach, and so I keep them here. I know this one is AB Studio and Snibart. Then I have next one with Maremi, Small Art. And then I have my favorite ones in the small size. So if you haven't seen a stamp junkie, it's me, and all of my stamps are here. So I took out two of the folders. I'm gonna show you quite quickly how they look. I really love the stamps, and if I crack and have some money on the side and I can buy myself something, I usually buy stamps. That's that. I also design stamps now, but I don't know why. I like to work also with other people's design. So here we go. I have them divided like that. I put them on the plastic and keep them like that. If they move too much, I am gonna use this. I'm gonna use the adhesive dots to keep them in place. Later, it's a little hard to. Can you see that, guys? I think to take them out because you have to unglue them, especially if the dots are fresh. But at least they are not falling out. Not all of them are done like that. Sometimes I just forget to put a dot or something. But and they are arranged in the case of stamps I love the most, or on the of the companies I love the most. They are arranged by companies, so not by theme. So here we had Oland Create stamps. Now there is Studio Light and also a beautiful Carabel Studio. I also have some, how do you call that? It's an art printing, which I use as a stamp also. Because it's designed to be used on the jelly plates, but I use it as a stamp. This is Viva Las Vegas stamps, which comes like that. I mean, I buy them like that. You can buy them also with the, you know, the backing, which is gluing to the, adhering to the block. But they are more expensive, so since I'm on budget, I'm buying them like that, and I'm placing them again with the small dots, so you can see it here, the small dots, and I put the name on them, Viva Las Vegas stamps. I also use these packets for pictures, so I put them like that. I don't even have to use the dots or anything, and they are just staying like that. And the other packets I didn't show you, they are divided into two. I don't know if you can see. So I have two packets here, like that. I'll try to find, this is Perfect Line. I don't know if it's a brand. I'll try to find you the links on the internet. Guys, this is the one of the nicest idea ever, or trick ever. This is a plastified album, and it was a Star Wars album. So basically an album which you can buy in a shop. When you go, you buy an album, it has usually already the covers of, for example, in this case, Star Wars. And then you can buy a small packet of few cards inside, and then you collect them and you slide them into the tiny packets which are here, like these ones. And you keep it here, and so I don't do that. I don't collect Star Wars, even though I like the movie, but I use that for my ATC cards. I replace the covers with the beautiful paper I got from my sister, and you can do it very easily because you have always opening here, so you can slide your favorite paper or maybe your drawing inside, and it works perfectly. And I did it on both sides, and here we go. That's how I keep my all of my ATC cards. And I usually put my ATC cards by date, but also by the theme. These ones were done for Maremi's Maremi's Small Art Creative Cafe Challenge. Those few. And those were swatches for Lindy's. But as you can see, I'm trying to stick to the themes. I love these ones very much. I keep it like that. My cards are quite bulky. You know, for example, this one, or this one. This one is maybe not that bulky, but it has some dimensions to it. And unfortunately, in this album, I have to flatten them, but still, they are at least protected, and they are fine that way. This one I made almost whole page, but I also have my watercolor ATC coins here. A little bit more of the cards, also arranged by theme, but also by the date I made them, kind of anyway. And the rest of my ATC coins. At the back I keep my printables for the back of ATCs, so like I can put the date and the title of them. And I also have the beautiful cards I got from my crafty friends. Having a children can be a really cool thing sometimes. No, most of the time, honest. You know, you can get some things from them. And so, for example, this was like a glitter paintings. These were glitter paintings for my daughter, but I love the box. This is the cardboard box. You can see it's a little damaged, but still it works fine. What do I have inside? Inside, I have all my photos. These are the photos I've chosen thinking that I'm gonna use them for my layouts or art journal pages. So they are more or less the same size, but not necessarily. So what I do is I buy a photo paper. I use the program for importing pictures into onto a paper, which gives me on the photo paper the size of A4. Gives me opportunity to put either 9 or 10 photos, just like that, you know, one beside the other or something like that, you know, imagine the A4 paper. And then I print them in a bulks, like so I print 2 or 3 pages at once, and I'll go through the page where I can find free photos, free for commercial use, no attribution required. And I'm gonna give you the link to this page just underneath, so you can also use it. So that's how I do with my pictures. I print them on the inkjet printer. Unfortunately, I don't have a laser one, but if I really want to protect them when I'm working with them, I can always apply a coat of clear gesso or matte gel. I don't usually also do that. When I work on the pictures, I put the normal paper tissue over them, and like that I can hold them, because if you hold them with your hands and look at me, I always have some paint on my hair, hands, you can just destroy them. Guys, thank you so much for watching. I hope this wasn't a total disaster, and I hope you'll join me in my next video. Have a crafty day. Bye bye.